wants to be a millionaire.
Woody Guthrie.
Got it for $32,000.
I believe it is Bolivia.
Did it for $64,000.
I think the audience has spoken. I have faith.
No, believe it or not, the correct answer is the Wall Street Journal.
I think I'm going to go with the audience, Regis. That's what I thought it was.
Well, let's see if the audience can vindicate itself. No, my gosh, it was Discovery. I'm so sorry. They did it again. The audience got another one. Who are these people? Where do they come from?
B.D. the Knesset.
Got it for $64,000.
I think I will have to walk away.
I'm going to say D, India, and hope that it's right.
Bollywood, India. Right answer. Now, join us from New York for Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Thank you very much, everybody. Good evening and welcome to Wednesday night at Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Well, it's the end of the ratings period here at network television, and you know what that means. All your favorite shows are going into what they call encore presentations. You know what that means? Fancy word for repeats. Not us, though. We'll have all new episodes because ABC just hates to see us rest, and because there are so many of you out there who want to get in on the game. Just like Jody Matzer from Missoula, Montana, who got up to $8,000 last night. Nice to see you again, Jody.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
And how did you sleep last night?
Not a wink.
No kidding. Not a one.
No,
huh?
I that's an exaggeration. Probably 20 minutes.
Mm-hmm. All those bits of trivia racing through your mind, huh?
Well, it was that, and New York's a little different from Missoula, you know, just a little.
Yeah. Missoula, Montana.
Missoula, Montana.
Matzer from Missoula.
That's me.
Okay.
The only, well, except for my wife, the only Matzer in Montana.
Yes, and your wife would be here, but she's accepting a law degree right now. Good for her. So you have your cousin back in the order, Cousin Nora. Nice to see you again.
Good to see you.
Nice to have her here. All right, now, what do you do for a living? We never covered that.
I'm a freelance illustrator. I have my own studio in Missoula.
Freelance illustrator.
Right.
Which means?
I'm on my own. It's my studio.
And you illustrate what?
I prefer something for children, like children's books or children's magazines.
And with the computer and all of that, you can stay in touch with everybody,
exactly,
right?
Exactly, yeah.
Well, good for you. Let's hope you win $1 million. All right, Jody, you've won $8,000. You're 7 questions away from winning $1 million. Here's how we play. The more questions you get right, the more money you win. Once you reach the $32,000 level, you're guaranteed to leave here with at least that much money. You have two of your lifelines left to help. Ask the audience, and you can phone a friend. Now, to play along with Jody, log on to the abc.com, click on the Enhanced TV logo, and play against everybody else at home using ABC's Enhanced TV. I think you'll enjoy it. Jody, you ready?
I am very
ready. Studio audience, are we ready? Yeah, come on, let's do it. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? He's 7 away from $1 million. Here it is for $16,000. Where is the famed 17th century Bridge of Sighs? Moscow, Berlin, Venice, Amsterdam.
Wow. You know, I really didn't want to have to use my life, so many lifelines before 32, but I don't want to leave. I'm enjoying my stay here, so I
want to
kind of play it smart.
We want you to stay, yes.
I want to play it smart here. I'm going to do call a friend.
Think you got somebody who knows what this is?
I think so.
Who is it?
Marty.
What does Marty do?
Marty is part owner of a computer company, computer supply company.
Is it in Missoula?
No, he's in Virginia.
All right, fine. Let's get Marty from Virginia on the line, AT&T. Thank you. Marty.
Yes.
Hi, Regis Philbin calling from ABC's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
Hi, Regis. How are you?
Well, we're pretty good here. We got a little problem, though. Jody's won $8,000. He's going for $16,000. Got a rather difficult question here. So he's going to come on the line, give you the question, and four possible answers, okay?
All right.
One of them is the right answer. All right, Jody, it's all yours. 30 seconds starts now.
Marty, where is the famed 17th century bridge of Sighs? The Bridge of Sighs. Moscow, Berlin, Venice, or Amsterdam?
Venice.
Venice?
Yes.
How sure are you, sir?
Pretty sure.
Pretty sure.
Yep.
Well, I appreciate your help.
You're welcome, Jody.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Marty has this right. He's my hero, too. It's a tough question.
It's a tough question, yeah. It really threw me for the first question. But I had him as a lifeline for specific reasons. He sounded very sure. I'm going to trust him. That's why I had him as a lifeline. He said Venice. I'm going to say C, Venice. That is my final answer.
Let's see how good Marty is. He's good. He's got it. You're six away from a million, one lifeline left. Here it is for $32,000. The Norse god Thor carries what magic weapon? Hammer, scythe, spear, sword.
Thor carries a hammer. A hammer, my final answer.
Got that one too for $32,000. Big guy from Big Sky.
Hey, there you go.
Five away from a million. Five away, huh?
Five away.
All right. Here it is for $64,000. What Academy Award-winning actress was a regular on the TV series A Different World? Mira Sorvino. Angelina Jolie. Marissa Tomei. Whoopi Goldberg.
I think she played one of the roommates. And I think it was Marissa Tomei. I'm going to say C, Marissa Tomei, my final answer.
You're something, pal. You got that one right for $64,000. Jody Matzer on a roll here. He's four away from 1 million, going for $125,000 when we come back.
Roger Ebert in the movies gives Shanghai two thumbs up. It's hilarious. Funnier than Rush Hour.
Ow.
I'm not going to walk with you if you walk like that.
Shanghai Noon, PG-13. Now playing.
Play the Milk Mustache Fame Game. Win millions of instant prizes or collect caps for the grand prize. To live the life of a celebrity. The Fame Game. Drink milk. Be famous.
Once upon a bedtime, there was a little prince who was very fussy. His loyal subjects tried settling him down, but nothing worked. Then his mom tried a warm bath with new Johnson's Bedtime Bath, which was recommended by pediatricians. The magical scent of lavender and chamomile filled the air, and the little prince settled down. Joy spread throughout the land.
New Johnson's Bedtime Bath. Not just gentle, Johnson's gentle.
If you thought botanicals were quiet, think again. Natural Instinct hair color enlivens your color, yet actually leaves your hair looking healthier and shinier than before. So your color really comes to life. Natural Instincts from Clairol.
I overcooked it?
Don't excuse your hair. Infuse your hair with Infusium 23 leave-in treatments.
Infusium repairs and even strengthens my damaged hair. You see the difference?
With Infusium 23 leave-in treatments.
New Chocolate Chewy Chips Ahoy!
We combined power and intelligence and created a way to clean your pipes like they've never been cleaned before. Liquid Plumber foaming pipe snake clog remover.
Here's one way to have fun this summer.
Soda Monster!
It's amazing what you can do with ice.
For more summer fun tips, watch Clerks. Brand new episodes tonight after Drew Carey on ABC.
We're back here with Jody Matzer from Missoula, Montana. He's very hot right now. He's won $64,000. He's going for $125,000 and still has one lifeline left. And you've been guarding that very judiciously, huh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let's talk. Too bad your wife isn't here to share in all the excitement.
She really wanted to be here.
She's picking up her law degree from the University of Montana?
Yes, sir.
Good for her. All right, Jody, I'm getting nervous. How about you? Wouldn't it be great to go back to Montana with $1 million?
You know it.
Oh, boy.
You know it.
All right, my man. $125,000 coming up. He's four away from $1 million. One lifeline. Let's play. In Greek mythology, what is the name of the creature that guarded Hades? Centaur, Charybdis, Cerberus, and Griffin.
Hades was the god of the underworld, and he had a three-headed dog, I think, that was his creature that was helping him guard Hades. Let's see. I think it's going to be Cerberus. Let's go. Centaur was in the maze. Griffin was a lion, eagle. I don't think it was in Hades. Charybdis, I think, if I remember correctly, was in the ocean. That's where, if you're stuck between a rock and a hard place, it comes from, you're stuck between Charybdis and the other creature. That's where that expression comes from. Only possible solution is going to be Cerberus, the three-headed dog. I'm going for C as my final answer, sir.
You had $64,000.
Yes, sir.
Now you got $125,000. Very, very impressive. Yeah.
Thank you.
Can this illustrator from Missoula, Montana, win the $1 million? Three questions away from $1 million right now, going for $250,000, and still that audience lifeline is with him. Here it is for $50,000. The poem, The Charge of the Light Brigade, immortalizes a battle fought during what war? Boer War. Hundred Years' War. American Revolution. Crimean War. Did you ever see the movie in the video store?
You know, there was a movie in the video store that may have been about the subject, but they called it something else.
I thought it was The Charge of the Light Brigade with Errol Flynn.
Was it Cary Grant?
What was that?
Was it Cary Grant?
No, it was Errol Flynn.
It was Errol Flynn.
I'll do the funny stuff,
okay,
please.
Okay, I'm sorry. I would very much appreciate if the audience would lend me a hand on this, please.
All right, audience, we need your help for $250,000 we're talking about here. On your keypads, using A, B, C, or D, please vote now. Not a lot of help. Not a lot of help.
Apparently they went to the same video store I went to.
Well, let's see who won that. The American Revolution?
American Revolution, I'm pretty sure it is.
People usually go to the audience for, you know, the $3,000 question.
Right. I'm from Montana. I'm kind of doing this, you know.
Anyway, the American Revolution got 34%. The next was the Crimean War, then the Hundred Years' War, and the Boer War got 9%.
Surprisingly, A is what I was thinking. I'm thinking that the Light Brigade was actually the Brigade of Light Horsemen, which were used in Australia. And the only battle that I can think that took place in Australia was the Boer War. I'm trying to remember the poem. My main goal for coming here was to get some money because my wife has been working extremely hard the last 3 years in law school.
Sure.
I'm very proud of her, and I want to get her a very nice gift to say how proud I am of her. $125,000 would get her a nice gift, and maybe put some money in the bank. It's more money than I've ever seen, and I don't want to lose it. I appreciate the audience's help.
You know you don't want to leave.
I don't. I really don't. I am having...
You're having a good time.
I'm having the best time. I really am. Charge
of the Light Brigade.
Charge of the Light Brigade. Regis, I have had a blast. Everyone here has been fantastic. It is a thrill of a lifetime meeting you.
Really? I want you to stay.
I'm from Montana. No, it has been an absolute thrill.
Listen, all kidding aside, you're a great contestant. Final decision to walk? You can't say it, can you? We're going to be here all night.
No. There are some very nice people that want to get up here. I always said I would go with my first instincts, and the Boer War is what I thought it was, but I'm not 100% sure. I'm going to leave.
Final decision?
Yes, sir. It is my final decision.
You know, I think it's the Boer War, too. But let me tell you something. I thought it was the Boer War, too. I was so sure. But you want to know what it was? The Crimean War. You're right to leave. $125,000. Yeah. Good luck, Jody. Okay, baby. Good luck. Great guy and a great contestant, too. A lot of fun. Well, on my screen, it told me that the Boer War was in South Africa, not Australia. And the Charge of the Light Brigade took place on October 25th, 1854, in Balaclava in the Crimea. A brigade of 600 British cavalry obeyed their orders and heroically charged the Russian line. All 600 men were lost. And yes, the movie did star Errol Flynn. But right now, we have 10 new contestants ready to go. Who are they tonight? Let's find out. And they are Mike Horan, Fort Mill, South Carolina. Steve Guinness, Dover, Delaware. Jennifer Bass, Newburgh, Oregon. Jim Faggiana, Woodbridge, Connecticut. Jim Arnold, Cotati, California. Bob Corwin, Larchmont, New York. Jane Henderson, Westchester, Pennsylvania. Barbara Jacobson, Tigard, Oregon. And Claudetta Knights, Redding, California. And Joyce Humphries, Deerfield Beach, Florida. Okay, everybody, welcome to our show. Good luck to you. Here's how it works from here on in. At a moment, a question and four answers will appear on your screens. The one who puts those answers in the correct order will be our next contestant, provided they do it in the fastest time. So if we're ready, audience, we need complete silence here. Thank you very much. Here comes the question. Put these fictional TV millionaires in the order their shows first debuted, starting with the earliest. Alexis Carrington, Maxwell Sheffield, Thurston Howell III, and J.R. Ewing. Okay, everybody, time's up. Let's see the answer in the correct order, starting with the earliest, Thurston Howell III, then J.R. Ewing, then Alexis, and finally, Maxwell Sheffield. And that's the right order. Who did it in the fastest time? The winner is Jim Faggiana. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Ready to go for it?
Yes, sir.
We'll be back in a minute with Jim Faggiana.
ESPN Sports Center update is brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light.
Can anybody win on the other team's home court? Hasn't happened yet. Knicks and Pacers game 5 tonight. In tennis, Andre Agassi begins defense of his French Open title with a straight set victory over Anthony Dupuis of France. On the women's side, a fat upset. Two seed Lindsay Davenport loses to unseeded Dominique Van Roos of Belgium. For this Coors Light update, I'm Stuart Scott. We're out here.
You want to take a break?
Yeah, I'm burning up.
So, are you having as good a time as I am? Oh, do you want to go somewhere more quiet? Don't you find me attractive?
Coors Light. Frost brewed at the edge of freezing.
Did you say something?
This Father's Day, imagine how thrilled Dad will be to wake up to Mach 3 from Gillette. Give him the best, the first triple blade razor for a shave he'll never forget. Mach 3 from Gillette.
The Edge Pizza from Pizza Hut is back. It's toppings on top of toppings with no outer crust to fence them in. Try the works recipe or create your own. But hurry, the Edge won't be around much longer. The Edge Pizza from Pizza Hut, another one of the best pizzas under one roof.
Congratulations! You finally made it.
Thanks.
Aww. So, you got your whole life ahead of you. What are you gonna do now?
Well, thought about working. Looked into retirement. Looks good. Gonna play a little canasta, shuffleboard, golf, eat a little shellfish, salsa Saturdays, bingo Mondays. I'm retiring.
Want a step you can really skip? New Cascade Complete helps you skip scrubbing and rinsing. Finally, skip the sink, cause food's dissolved away.
Where'd you get that sweater vest?
New from Cascade. Cascade Complete. Skip the sink.
Sunday on the wonderful World of Disney.
Hi, we're the Ducks.
JV varsity games on Friday. Then we'll show the whole school what a joke you really are.
They came.
I want a piece of these guys.
They saw.
Bring it on.
They kicked a little.
Oh, my, what a hit.
Emilio Estevez and Joshua Jackson.
Shoot!
D3, the Mighty Ducks. ABC Sunday, 7, 6 Central.
Sweetie, I'll be right back.
Okay.
Forecast mostly sunny skies today with brisk easterly winds. Expect a high near 52 degrees.
Perhaps it will be traded for a tuna fish sandwich. Or maybe it will be forgotten on the back seat of the bus. But more likely than not, it will be the envy of all the other executives in the board meeting. Stop and Shop.
Thanks a lot, honey.
All the ingredients.
What if your car knew you, anticipated your needs, and then reacted to meet them? What if it could help protect you in an accident, with sensors that know where your seat's positioned and the severity of the crash, so the front airbags can react to you? What if it went even further? It's time to stop wondering what if. Introducing the new 2000 Ford Taurus with the advanced personal safety system.
Watch News Channel 8's Morning Team weekdays starting at 5.
Jim Faggiana from Woodbridge, Connecticut, in the hot seat right now. He is a software engineer, has been for most of his adult life, huh?
Just about all of it.
And your wife is also involved in computers as well, isn't she?
Yes, sir.
Is it Sandra?
Yes,
Regis. How are you, Sandra?
Yeah.
What do you do?
Hi, Regis. I'm an information technology person. I take care of a bunch of computers.
Boy, it must be wonderful. The whole family's involved in the next century here. And I can't even open my computer, believe it or not. Can't get it open, Jim.
Really? I'd rather not see them when I come home.
I'll bet. I'll bet you're tired of them. But you went to Notre Dame, huh?
Yes, I did.
You lived in the same dorm as Joe Montana?
Yeah, he lived right down the hall from me, both of our freshman year.
All right, Jim, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Ready to go here?
Yes, sir.
Are you nervous?
I'll let you know.
Okay. You know the rules, Jim. You know the lifelines, 50-50. Ask the audience, phone a friend. So if you're ready, Mr. Faggiana, let's play You Wants to Be a Millionaire. Here we go. For $100, Jim, take a look. According to an old phrase, what does a coward have running down his back? Blue blood, yellow streak, red ants, ponytail.
Hopefully that would be a yellow streak.
Yes, that's what a coward has, a yellow streak. $200. Which of the following grows on a pine tree? Ball, cone, star, money.
How about a bee, cone?
Cone, the right answer, Jim. $200. We go for $300 right now. What feature allows your vehicle to maintain speed without having to keep your foot on the gas pedal? Is it power steering, bucket seats, cruise control, telekinesis?
I'm going to go with C, cruise control.
Right answer. Good for you, Jim. Cruise control. Some of these Notre Dame guys, very serious, but that's good, Jim. That's good. Here it is for $500. Come on. What object did the Titanic hit which caused the ship to sink? Iceberg. Another ship. Whale. Oil rig.
Titanic hit an iceberg. Hey.
Iceberg, the right answer, Jim, for $500. Good. $1,000. What is the name for the part of speech that modifies a verb? Adjective, preposition, conjunction, adverb.
Okay. Adjective modifies a noun. An adverb modifies a verb. D, final.
Right for $1,000. You know, I know exactly how you feel and what you're going through. On those first five questions, a lot of people think, well, they're ridiculously easy. But when you're sitting there, sometimes you can't put it all together.
Can't think straight.
But you're doing fine. You got your three lifelines. Jim, we're going for $2,000. We're 10 away from a million. Let's do it. Here it comes for $2,000. What U.S. state shares its name with a country bordering the Black Sea? Nevada, Virginia, Georgia, Ohio.
Republic of Georgia borders the Black Sea, so that's C, Georgia, final answer.
See that? $2,000. What's the problem? $4,000. Here it comes. What part of an orange is known as the zest? Juice, seeds, peel, pulp.
Peel. Okay, I'm gonna have to, I don't want to get knocked out here. I'm gonna have to ask the audience.
Why not? Why don't we do it? Audience, Jim needs your help. On your keypads using A, B, C, or D, please vote now. Well, there you go. 82% say it was the peel. It's pretty overwhelming.
I wasn't sure exactly where the pulp was, so I'm going to go with the audience and say C, peel. Final answer.
Final answer, and it's the right answer for $4,000. Eight away from a million, Jim. Here it is for $8,000. The filaments of most incandescent light bulbs are made of what? Tungsten, copper, platinum, titanium.
I'm pretty sure it's tungsten filament, so that would be A. Let me just review the other ones and make sure.
Sure.
It has to be tungsten. I'm gonna say A, final. Tungsten.
Yes, it's tungsten for $8,000, Jim. Doing good. We're going to take a break. When we get back, he's going for $16,000.
Hi, I'm Smitty. I guess you could call me a plethora of information. For this, you're going to need a blower. Maybe a vac.
Customers look at me as the answer guy. If they've got a question, they need an answer, they come to me. All you need here is a cordless push mower. I'm going to give you everything you need to take care of your yard.
Tractor. Definitely the lawn tractor.
We've got everything you could possibly imagine in power tools. All kinds of stuff.
String trimmer.
I'm basically here to make sure the customer gets what he needs for the job.
The Home Depot, where low prices are just the beginning.
Blue.
What's up?
Well, actually, I could go for some chocolate.
You're a Baldwin, right?
Yeah.
Which one?
I'm Steven.
Well, I would have expected better, Steven.
Better what?
Your performance. Go for some chocolate. I didn't believe for a second you were going to eat me.
Really?
Honestly, not your best work.
All right, fine. I'll go back out here and try it again, all right? Blue?
No blue aqui.
Buddy?
Go away.
You know, I want everyone to remember 7-Up forever. So I'm going to project our logo on the moon with a giant laser.
Okay! Who has been messing with my laser?
Imagine, adventure lies just around the river bend, like in Pocahontas. New to the Walt Disney Gold Classic Collection, coming to video and Disney DVD June 6th. Imagination for a lifetime.
I just colored the life back into my hair.
Laboratoire Garnier creates Nutrice NutriColor Mask.
It's a first in permanent hair color.
The Nutrice Mask nourishes as it colors.
It's like a beauty mask, but for your hair.
Nutrice puts nourishing conditioners and fruit oil right in with the color.
That's when you need it.
You'll feel the difference.
And the color, vibrant.
To give you a lift or a change.
Or give you back the color you were born with.
Nutrice NutriColor Mask, guaranteed by Laboratoire Garnier, the European expert in home hair color.
No. I said sell it. Just
call them up and ask them to give it all back.
Hi.
Oh, please don't take those.
In this point-and-click, risk-it-all-on-a-dot-com world...
What's wrong with this phone?
It's nice to know at least one thing doesn't go up and down. Wendy's Super Value Menu.
Hi. Junior bacon cheeseburger, side salad, and a biggie drink.
Because everything is always 99 cents.
Wait a minute. It's on us.
It's there for you. And remember, Wendy's pickup windows open late, so you can eat great.
Thanks for stopping.
Even late.
Friday, they're 8 talented, ambitious guys who want one thing.
I've always loved piano and music and all that kind of stuff, and I would love to make a living at it.
But only 5 of them can make the band.
There's going to be a lot of rough feelings.
And the competition's a killer.
Oh, you might not like me after.
You'll see what finally crushes the dream for one of them.
You can see it in his eyes that he didn't want to leave, but he had to for some reason.
All new all summer, Making the Band, Friday on ABC.
Jim Faggiana from Woodbridge, Connecticut, in that hot seat right now. He's going for $16,000. I was saying that your wife, Sandra, is enjoying the show. She's smiling back there, having a good time, and while you're, you know, in agony up here.
Yes, sir.
All right, Jim, you're all settled down now. You're cruising right along, feeling strong, right? Feeling better? We're going for $16,000 right now, 7 away from $1 million. Let's play. Here we go. In the animated TV series King of the Hill, what is Hank Hill's profession? Fast food manager, truck mechanic, refrigerator repairman, propane gas salesman.
I am going to have to use another lifeline.
Sure.
And this time, I'm going to phone a friend.
Who would that be?
And that friend would be my sister, Joan.
She follow this show, do you think?
Hopefully.
All right, good. Well, let's find out together if she does, all right? AT&T, we need Joan. Thanks.
Hello?
Joan?
Hello?
Hello, Joan?
Yes,
Regis Philbin calling from New York. How are you?
Hi, Regis. It's so nice to hear your voice.
Well, thank you. Nice to talk to you, too. I've got your brother Jim here.
Okay.
He loves you.
I love him, too.
Yes, and he needs your help.
We're going to help him.
All right. He's going for $16,000 right now, so he's going to come on, give you the question, the 4 answers. One of them's the right answer, okay?
Okay.
All right, good. Okay, Jim, all yours. 30 seconds right now.
In the TV series King of the Hill, what is Hank Hill's profession?
King of the Hill TV series, what is Hank Hill's profession?
Either answers, fast food manager, truck mechanic, refrigerator repairman, propane gas salesman.
Propane gas salesman, 100% sure.
Okay, you want to think about it? We got 7 seconds.
No, we don't want to think about it.
How are the kids?
Jim, she said 100% sure.
Okay, well, what am I going to do?
Talk about the kids later.
I got 8 seconds.
No, I know you didn't. That was nice.
All right,
She sounded pretty confident.
I will go with her answer, which was propane gas salesman D. Final answer.
She was right, propane gas salesman. You won $16,000. 6 away from a million for $32,000. Take a look. The phrase manifest destiny was first used in the 1840s to justify what U.S. movement? Territorial expansion. Abolition of slavery. Women's suffrage. Prohibition.
Okay, I think I know this. Just rereading it again. And I'm pretty sure that the manifest destiny had to do with territorial expansion, U.S.'s right to expand. So I'm going to take a calculated risk and not use the lifeline, and I'm going to say A, territorial expansion, and that is my final answer.
That's your final answer, huh?
Yes, sir.
The right answer. You got it. $32,000. Five away from $1 million right now. Going for $64,000. You won $32,000. Can't leave here with less than that. And one lifeline left. Let's do it. $64,000. In the 1982 movie Tootsie, where does Dustin Hoffman's character work in the fictional TV soap opera? Law office, bank, hospital, restaurant?
Dorothy Michaels, I think she was. He. And I'm pretty sure that was in a hospital. Yep, I'm gonna go with that. C, hospital. Final answer.
I love the way you say it. And you said it right. Hospital, the right answer for $64,000. Okay, up to $125,000 now, Jim. Can you believe it?
No.
Four away from a million. Here it is. Having gained fame as a child prodigy, Midori is renowned for playing what instrument? Violin, piano, flute, cello.
Something a little light went on when you said piano. But no, I'm definitely going to use a 50-50 on this one.
Why don't we do it? Computer, take away two of the wrong answers for Jim, leaving one wrong answer and the correct one. Well, turn that light out.
Light is
out. It's either the violin or the cello.
Okay. I am going to guess. And I'm going to guess D, cello.
Any reason why?
None at all. D, cello. Final answer.
Darn it, it was the violin. But you won $32,000, Jim.
Take it.
And it was a lot of fun having you here.
Thank you.
And go Irish.
Yes, sir.
Okay, buddy. Thanks. Not this one, Jim. Bye. Bye-bye. Well, that's Jim. Yeah, I'm gonna miss Jim. Not that I favor Notre Dame guys in that chair, but anyway, good luck to him. Now, we still have more contestants ready to go, so here's the next fastest finger question. Here it comes. Put the following movies in order of their first theatrical release, starting with the earliest. Big, The Big Chill, Big Daddy, Big Night. Everybody, time's up. Let's see the answer in the correct order, starting with the earliest film, Big Chill, then Big Night, finally Big Daddy. Let's see who got it right in the fastest time. The winner, Jane Henderson. Congratulations. Very good. Gonna go for a million? Yeah, we're gonna play with Jane in just a moment.
Pure, gentle Johnson's. 8 out of 10 pediatricians choose it for their own babies for one profoundly simple reason. They're parents who care about gentleness just as much as you do. Only Johnson's Baby Shampoo has the exclusive No More Tears formula that's as gentle to eyes as pure water. Johnson's Baby Shampoo. Not just gentle, Johnson's gentle.
McDonald's Hatch, Match, and Win game, based on Walt Disney Pictures' Dinosaur. And you could win some very cool prizes. Maybe even $1 million. Just match up the parts. Dinosaur parts.
Want to go outside and play? Need new toys? You've got just 72 hours to get here and save some cash. Now at the Sears 72-hour sale. All gas and electric trimmers are at very trim prices. Take half off this 8.4-volt Craftsman drill. It's only 3 days. It's only at Sears, where the coolest stuff in the neighborhood is on sale. So come out and play. The 72-hour sale at Sears. The good life at a great price, guaranteed.
Cream more exciting? Pour on Hershey's chocolate syrup.
Let's call our new puppy Jack.
Yeah. Uh-oh, he got into the garbage.
Uh-oh, he found the bathroom.
New Clorox disinfecting wipes. It's from Clorox, so it's more than clean.
Uh-oh, paw prints.
Have you learned anything from this experience?
Hi, welcome to the new Friendlies.
Discover an incredibly tempting treat. Friendlies soft serve ice cream, irresistible Reese's peanut butter cups, and delicious hot fudge and peanut butter toppings. All of them put together. It can only be the Reese's peanut butter cup cyclone. Cool, it's luscious, it's craveable, and there's no wrong way to eat one. The Reese's Peanut Butter Cup Cyclone, only at the new Friendlies.
All across the country, winter is finally turning to spring. And now, with the National Jeep Spring Event, you can explore all of the season's surprises. Change your whole perspective with an incredible $299 a month lease on Grand Cherokee Laredo. And climb to new heights with exceptional capability, luxury, and style. The world looks different from behind the wheel of a legendary 4x4. So get to your dealer today before this event takes off for the season. See your New England Jeep dealer.
If you'll look at the numbers, I think you'll find everything is...
Hello?
No, this is Timmy's father.
I have no idea when they're trading Pokemon cards.
This Pokemon...
No, Susie isn't here. Steve broke up with you.
Okay, I'll tell her.
Susie said to tell you that Steve guy is a real jerk, and she's your best friend for life.
Need more wireless phones for your family? Get Family Talk from SNET with phones for everyone and shared minutes, all on one simple phone bill. Family Talk from SNET.
Jane Henderson from Westchester, Pennsylvania, in our hot seat right now. Congratulations, Jane.
Thank you very much.
What do you do for a living?
I'm an analyst in a computer software firm.
Really? Wow. Good for you. And you're accompanied by a good friend of yours, Marianne, I guess, whom you've known since high school days?
Since high school.
Anyway, it's nice to have you here. You know the rules, Jane. You know about the lifelines, 50-50. Ask the audience and phone a friend. It's all here for you. So if you're ready, Jane Henderson, let's do it. Let's play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Here we go. For $100. The London Fog Company is best known for making outerwear, which protects the wearer from what? Sun, rain, earthquakes, mafia.
The answer is B, rain.
Yes, B, rain is the right answer. $200. If you drive a freight truck, what type of fuel are you most likely to use in your rig? Rocket, diesel, unleaded, moonshine?
The answer is B, diesel.
Diesel, the right answer for $200. Here we go for $300. What part of the body is given special treatment during a manicure? Hands, feet, hair, kidney?
The answer is A, hands.
Yes, hands, the right answer. $500, Jane. Which of these is the primary source of nicotine? Ginger root, tobacco leaves, chili peppers, seaweed?
The answer is B, tobacco leaves.
Yes, tobacco leaves is the right answer. Primary source of nicotine. Here we go for $1,000. The grooves on the top of a Phillips head screw form what shape? Cross, diamond, circle, triangle?
The answer is A, cross.
Cross, the right answer for $1,000. So you're off and running. All your lifelines are with you. We're going for $2,000, 10 away from a million. Take a look. Where would you find the United States Air Force Academy? Annapolis, Maryland? Biloxi, Mississippi? Colorado Springs, Colorado? West Point, New York?
The answer is C, Colorado Springs, Colorado.
Final answer?
Yes.
Air Force Academy located in Colorado Springs. She's right. $4,000. In which author's works would you find the characters Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail? Mother Goose, Beatrix Potter, Lewis Carroll, A.A. Milne?
I'm going to go with Beatrix Potter.
Final answer?
Yes.
Beatrix Potter, the right answer. $4,000. Well, you saved those lifelines, okay, and you're doing just fine. You're 8 away from 1 million. Here it is for $8,000. In the 1991 film, The Silence of the Lambs, Dr. Lecter recounts a meal that included fava beans and what? Merlot, Burgundy, Chianti, Champagne.
The answer is C, Chianti.
Final answer?
Yes.
Fava beans and Chianti, the right answer, yes. We'll take a break. She's doing just great. When we come back, she's going for $16,000.
For you.
keys are in it.
The Accord V6 Coupe from Honda. It's one powerful car.
Ma'am, why the turmoil?
Lifesavers! They've hidden away all these bags and rolls of Lifesavers that are like all pineapple?
And if you find one, you win its weight in gold!
Lifesavers Gold Fever is spreading fast!
There's gold in that store!
Catch it while you can!
When you live with guys, you learn all kinds of things, like independence. Patience. Not to mention biological warfare.
At least shaving's never been easier with Soak Effects Plus. A shower hanger puts it where you need it. Guard wires help prevent cuts under any circumstance.
Can it! Did I mention patience?
Soak Effects Plus. Shaving made easy.
There's something about that honey barbecue sauce. Hitting those three big strips of crispy chicken. And all that melted Monterey Jack cheese hitting that sauce. And every bite tastes better than the bite before. Oh, baby!
Maybe I spend too much time thinking about that new sandwich from KFC. Maybe not.
Get over to KFC for the new Honey Barbecue Crunch Melt. Hurry, it's only here for a short time.
It's that good.
Airfare for two, bought online. $1,900. One motorbike, two helmets, 9,300 yuan. Map, 47 yuan. Crossing number six off your life's to-do list? Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Accepted wherever your travels may take you.
Reynolds Kitchen, sir. We've got a report of a missing mom.
She's in the kitchen.
Bingo.
Dad's at the grill.
Mom's stuck inside making the rest of the meal. She needs to cook it all together in Reynolds hot bags.
A no-hassle meal with no messy cleanup and no missing moms.
Does this look like a bribe to you?
And so you're sure that would be $1,000.
Or how about this? So why are these busted politicians denying it?
You can look at that tape. Look at him hand you $1,000 and say, so help me God, that's not a bribe?
Did they see what we just saw? Bribes, fraud, and an FBI. Gotcha. 2020 tonight.
Here's one way to have fun this summer.
Soda Monster!
It's amazing what you can do with ice.
For more summer fun tips, watch Clerks. Brand new episodes tonight after Drew Carey on ABC.
A tug of war over the Martin Luther King Jr. holiday.
Jane Henderson, Westchester, Pennsylvania, in the hot seat right now. Jane's really a fan. She's been watching the show, she says, practically every night, right?
Very true.
And been on the phone trying to become qualified as a contestant almost every night, too.
Desperately trying.
Really? Why did you want to be a contestant so bad?
I just love the show. I love trivia.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to win $1,000,000.
Of course. What a silly question I asked, huh? Wants to win $1,000,000. Well, you came to the right place. So you have all your lifelines. You're going for 16,000. Should you miss here, you'll lose $7,000. Well, let's take a look at it now. For 16,000, let's play. Which of the following is a traditional bread of India? Focaccia, pita, naan, tortilla.
I'd like to ask the audience.
Want to ask the audience? Sure. Audience, Jane needs your help. On your keypads, using A, B, C, or D, please vote now. Sevent 4% say none. Pita came in second at 22%.
Well, since I don't know, I'm going to have to trust the audience and go with C, none.
Final answer?
Final answer.
They were right. She won 16,000. an important question for $32,000. Betty Shabazz was the wife of what American historical figure? Malcolm X, Martin Luther King Jr., Medgar Evers, Muhammad Ali.
The answer is A, Malcolm X.
Final answer?
Yes.
Malcolm X, the right answer. Five away from a million right now. We're looking at the $64,000 question. On the TV series Magnum P.I., Thomas Magnum usually wears the baseball cap of what team? Chicago Cubs, Boston Red Sox, Detroit Tigers, Los Angeles Dodgers.
I have an inkling, but I think I'm going to phone a friend.
Who do you want to call?
That would be Craig.
Who's Craig?
Craig's a co-worker.
Co-worker of yours? All right, fine. We'll get Craig on the line, AT&T, and see if she can help. Or he can help.
Hello?
Hello, Craig.
Yes, Regis.
Yeah, how are you?
All right, how are you?
Knew I was calling, huh?
Had an idea you were calling, yes.
Well, Jane Henderson is here.
Uh-huh.
She asked for your help, and we hope you could give it to her.
Okay.
She's going for $64,000 right now.
Going for $64,000, okay.
All right, so she's going to read you the question, the four answers. One of them is the right answer, all right?
Okay.
All right, good luck.
Thank you.
So, Jane, 30 seconds right now.
Craig, this is TV question. On Magnum P.I., Thomas Magnum usually wears the baseball cap of what team? Chicago Cubs, Boston Red Sox, Detroit Tigers, Los Angeles Dodgers.
I can't even think about this. I'm trying to picture it. I see it. I think it's the Boston Red Sox, but I'm not sure. That's the best I can do.
Okay, thanks, Greg.
Didn't sound too confident. You still have a 50-50. Certainly you took a look at Tom Selleck while that series was on, didn't you, Jane?
Unfortunately, I was not paying attention to his
hat. Come on, you... couldn't take your eyes off him.
Let's do the 50-50.
Okay, good idea. Computer, take away two of the wrong answers, please, leaving Jane one wrong answer and the correct one. Red Sox and Tigers. I tell you what, you thinking of the cap now or you thinking of Selleck?
I'm trying to think of the cap.
Okay.
Well, no matter what, I've got 32. My instinct is that it's Detroit Tigers, so I'm going to go with Detroit Tigers.
Going to make that your final answer?
Yes.
And you got it right for $64,000. Oh. Well, just in time did we hear the sound that says we're out of time for tonight, but Jane will be back here tomorrow night, and joining her will be 10 new contestants who have flown in from all over the country. And they are Debbie Elfrid, Johnny White, Julia Thomas, Chris Winnington, Fred Shapiro, Scott Goodman, Michael Simon, Andrea Reynolds, Carl Cope, and Greg White. Hey, if you can't get enough of Millionaire, pick up the all-new version of the Who Wants to Be a Millionaire CD-ROM at stores near you and at abc.com. Stay tuned now for the Drew Carey Show, followed by the premiere of Clerks. See you back here tomorrow night, okay? At 9, 8 Central. From New York, everybody. Good night.
For continued Millionaire fun, be sure to check out the Millionaire Store, play the online game, and find out about the Millionaire Sweepstakes, only at abc.com, part of the Go Network.